R.I. Presents.
Sea People, Mountain People, Chapter 2. Encounter with Mythology. Previous overview. While the Tokapcup and the others were knitting at home, a group of men appeared angrily. While everyone shrugged and feared, Tokapcup's mother responded to the angry men. When the men were asked by Tokapcup's mother what they were doing, he replied, "The man here must have taken the woman. Bring a woman," the man in the lead replied in an angry voice. Mother, who had not heard Tokapcup's explanation at this point, replied, "What are you talking about?" The man replied, "You know that." The man yelled, so Tokapcup went next to her mother and told her the details of the events. After making sure she hadn't seen the woman, her mother turned to the men. To the man in the lead, her said, "There is no one you are looking for, and we have not met. Besides, you were the ones who threw stones at them and drove them away." The mother said and glared at the man. Old men and men who heard the commotion began to gather around, and the atmosphere became more and more grim. Began to look around, probably confused when they saw the people who had gathered. And then, the disgusting man whispered something to the man in the lead. After listening to his companion, the man glared at his surroundings for a moment before saying, "If you find a woman around here, I will sanction you," and then they walked away. Watching the men leave, I turned around to see Yukikima standing right behind me, and he smiled and nodded slightly when his eyes met Tokapcup. When I saw his smile and said in a small voice, "Yukikima likes Tokapcup," I could feel her surprise and bewilderment. She hurriedly grabbed her mother's hand and said, "Let's go home," and took her home with her. On the way home, I said in a small voice, "It's cute," and she shook her head sharply, and at the same time her steps quickened, and her mother asked, "What's wrong?" But she ignored mother and hurried home. At the front of the house, Grandma was waiting for us, and when she saw us, she smiled and walked inside. We followed Grandma into the house. Then her mother, who was behind her, asked her, "What's wrong?" When Tokapcup turned around, her mother looked us at her hand and asked, "Do you still want to hold hands?" Tokapcup hurriedly let go of her hand. Her mother asked, "I want to ask you a lot of questions, but first tell me a little more about Yasuo." "He hearing her mother's words, she seemed to regain her composure, and after a little laugh, she explained in detail how things happened and what happened in Yasso Village. And as for the Wajin who helped Yukikima, she added that the man came to Kodan and was looking for someone named Kushinada. However, she told her mother that she felt a little uncomfortable when the man asked if anyone knew the weather. When her mother heard this, she looked a little surprised, then put her hands on Tokapcup's shoulders and said in a strong tone, "Don't tell anyone that you can see the color of the wind." Tokapcup replied, "Yes, but I was a little worried when I listened to her mom and felt that something bad was about to happen." I whispered, "Are you okay?" And Tokapcup remembered me and started telling her mother about me. Mom was a little surprised, saying, "Was it a different person?" "Different people. What do you mean?" Tokapcup is also confused. "What? Saw her confused face, she smiled and patted Tokapcup on the head, saying, "I thought I could hear to your voice." Then Mom looked straight at me and asked, "Are you an ancestor?" When Tokapcup replied that she was not an ancestor, her mother was a little surprised. This time, I did not yet understand all of the Ainu language, so I did not realize that there was an important phrase in the words spoken by her mother. So Tokapcup said to her mother, "I can't hear my ancestors' voices, so she's a good person to talk to, and I've learned a lot of the language of the Wajin." Seemed even more surprised, and when she muttered, "The language of the Wajin," she stared at me silently. I don't know what her mom is thinking, but I have a lot to ask her. So I decided to take this opportunity to ask her mother about various things. Story ends. The story is updated next Saturday. Please look forward to. If you like, please subscribe to the channel. See you again.